Tamer's revenge is gonna be charged up and jumping right onto Jawhead. But it doesn't seem like the most of the action is gonna be right there as Valia immediately just goes straight down and take a look at the bottom side. It doesn't seem like Freya is gonna be fighting one against the Jawhead. He's gonna go down, unfortunately. But looking back at the rest of the action, DVT is still kind of still alive. But Jawhead trying to get him smart missiles down onto Selena, managed to do exactly that. And that is going to be a 3-4-3 trade-off. But the main difference is, will Grok go down? I don't think that Grok is gonna be alive any longer. He went back and gave the kill over to Forza instead? Questionable. Looking at the score, it could pretty much go to anyone. DVT or EVOS might be the answer. And looking at this, EVOS is just gonna be completely jumping on the DVT. We do have Fist Break immediately on a Pokemon. He doesn't seem to be faulted at all. He is the Freya after all. He's gonna be tanky. He's gonna be dealing a lot of damage. And Valir goes down. We do have another one coming from the side. Jawhead gets a kill on the Pokemon, but he's not gonna be getting out alive anytime soon. But looking at it on top, Andremir as well as the Grok, they are still trying to put themselves into a good position. But looking at this, Immortality popped. He's still gonna come back up. Andremir goes down. WJ is gonna be the next one in the kill list. But looking at things, he's gonna put himself back into base and will be able to live to see another day. Looking at kind of a comeback coming in from DVT, if you ask me. The Lord is fighting for their cause and pushing down from the top lane. Not looking good as the entirety of DVT is pushing down in the middle lane. They managed to do quite so. And with the Lord still alive, they are working onto the core. But looking at the bottom side, we do have Fizzbridge just going to be used by Madama. Doesn't seem like he's going to be staying alive anytime soon. And the entirety of DVT, they are off down. Jawhead is really getting himself away. He couldn't get himself away from all of that. But he's still fighting back with a sliver of health. Forza went in for the maximum charge and immediately pops his head up and decapitated him. Grok's gonna be the next one on the side. And of course, within the kill list, even Guardian Wall is not able to hold him back.
Wiped out.
The entirety of EVOS Esports, they have got the advantage now. The all five of DVT is now down with the creep slowly marching in from the middle lane. And onto the core, JPL and Pokemon as well as Forza, they're just going to immediately backdoor onto the core. But is this enough? Would they have enough time? The next one coming in 6 seconds, but without a doubt, they manages to get it. They can risk everything all for that 1-0. The hyper carry may be working out pretty well, I'm not too sure, but if you ask me, Claude is pretty darn scary. Sanguine Claws immediately pushing JPL, or rather pulling JPL right into the targets of Claude with one kill credited away. They may be looking at the next one, Soul trying to save Forza, but unfortunately I don't think that is gonna be the case at all. With Blazing Duet immediately melting down one after another, DVT managed to secure the turtle, and that is a great, great thing. But looking at things at the bottom lane, that seems like it's gonna be a bloodshed, and so is middle lane. Immediately, JBL stood no chance. The Force Ejector coming in immediately forces himself out of position. Pokemon jumps straight in with the Falling Star Moon, but that may be the worst positioning and the worst timing to ever go in and gives the kill over. As you know, EVOS, they're up to something. Tyrant's Revenge channeling up, dry onto no one, unfortunately, but it's okay. He is in the heart of the enemies, and with that all said and done, Pokemon HP is down to the 50%, but Aeon is going to be the one that's going to be targeted by pretty much everyone. With Freya crediting the kill, we do have Blazing Duet just going to be happening right on the backside, and blazing a lot of people down without a doubt. JPL and Soul is going to be the only one available coming from EVOS Esports. Doesn't seem like they are able to work something out with the Sanguine Claw immediately repositioning himself, and DVT managed to get all four people down with no casualties. EVOS realizes that they really need to do something right here, but I don't think this is that something that they are looking for. With Esmeralda immediately goes straight down, and the entirety of whoever is going to be at the bottom lane was linked in by the Fatal Link, and Aeon is going to be the only one available from the bottom lane. This is going to be a split push from top lane and bottom lane though. Is it worth it though? I don't know, as Aeon is now down. Soul is going to be the next one remaining together with Forza. Just the two of them, Jawhead and Carry, is left to defend the middle lane as well as the bottom lane, because that is the two lanes that is completely barren. They have put all their cards in, all their eggs into one single basket to bring down the turret in the top and the bottom lane. And unfortunately, the inhibitor turret is still available. Force ejector did not happen. Soul is gonna go down as Adamir. The movement speed and attack speed is just a little bit too fascinating and way too much. Jawhead was not able to hold his own. The entirety of DVT is ready to push down right on the core. Take a look at this, Andremir doesn't care in the world of what Pokemon is doing. Immediately hacking it all in onto the core, and the core is down for that 1-1 victory. The turtle is not really given to anyone right now, but it does seem like EVOS Esports is immediately pushing down on the turtle. Now the turtle is less than 50% HP. Tyrant's Revenge, Tyrant's Rage, Aeon goes down! And it doesn't seem like it's going to be alive for any time soon. So immediately goes in and pretty much wraps everyone together. Take a look at the amount of Rhapsody! Damage! Right onto Adam here! And he goes down! Falsa, as our soul is still pretty much alive, but JPL trying to get himself away. Soul sacrifice himself. Make sure that Soul JPL is able to come alive. But Pokemon, he came back in! What's going on? This is a disaster! And just like that, we have more people going down one after another. EVOS Esports, why? Most attention is definitely going to be on the lane here on EVOS, but I think that attention needs to go on to Uranus as he's currently being pushed out by the jaw hit and immediately goes straight down. There was absolutely nothing he could do. Good Guardian Wall coming from Aeon, if you ask me. Just going to be pushing WQXD away and repositioning themselves. And now they manage to break him away and bring him down easily, just like that. Middle lane, top lane, bottom lane, everything is gone now. And well, EVOS Esports, they managed to turn the tides around, and this is going to be the final fight that they really needed. All they gotta do is to bring one down and one after another. Maybe they can position themselves right. The WJ, he himself put himself in the wrong position as he went in for the Tyrant's Revenge. He managed to get himself quickly out, so that is pretty much A-OK. But in the meantime, we do have the Death Starter coming in from Fossa from the other side, managed to deal a lot of damage with Jawhead immediately going down. We do have three men down, looking for five men down going in. But Fossa, he goes down. Pokemon is down as well. It's gonna be left with JPL Aeon as well as Soul. Will they be able to do anything? EVOS Esports, how are you going to do this? WJ, WQXD, he goes down. They're going immediately going for the next one. Onto the core, they don't care. And just like that, they manages to get the core. My oh my, what a tough game. EVOS Esports, what? This could potentially be the last game already, provided that EVOS Esports actually win this one. And Pokemon immediately with the Way of the Dragon W onto WQXD. Three men rotate coming in from EVOS. They are going back to the top lane and hopefully be able to get a kill on WQXD now. Playing as a Uranus, oh, as much as he is tanky, as much as Uranus is played as the tanky offlaner, there is absolutely no way they can get away. Or perhaps not, he can't get away. Oh, nope, Feather Airstrike from JPL definitely secures the kill and managed to bring him down to earth. EVOS Esports, well, they're either knocking on Death's door or knocking the door to victory. But looking like it's going to be a door to victory as they manage to bring Swoop and WQXD down. They're looking at more, or perhaps not that more, as Pokemon's HP is down to a sliver. Middle and bottom lane inhibitor turret is already down. They are looking at the top tower down, and Pokemon go straight in for the Wheel Dragon. So bold, but so rewarding at the same time. And that may pretty much be the game-winning kill. There is absolutely nothing for DVT to do. And just like that, ladies and gentlemen, EVOS Esports is your Singapore representative for MLI.